Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, the market has recorded, I would say, a decent price increase for the last 24 hours. But this is really pleasant because in this way, we can see that the price charts of the major cryptocurrencies, they continue to increase in price. So this is really nice, because we are cryptocurrency enthusiasts. And I want to say that today is Friday, that's why I will just mention a couple of interesting news relating to the cryptocurrency world that I find funny, interesting, cool, and useful. That's why let me start. The first one is relating to our beautiful Hive blockchain ecosystem. So this is one of the main, let's say, frontends or applications giving access to the Hive blockchain. This is the Hive block. Of course, it has the most simple user interface, and there are many different dApps that you can use. But I just wanted to show this one because it consists of some words, and one of them is Hive. So we see easily that this is Hive. And I want to say that Hive is really great. As I used to mention in my previous analysis, I think that this is the second most solid ecosystem for smart contracts, just behind after Ethereum. And once again, I think that such ecosystem like Polkadot, Cardano, for example, and all those ecosystems for smart contracts such as EOS, Tron, and etc., they are inferior to Hive. Hive is much more than all those platforms for smart contracts combined. And I have voiced my opinion many times, and this is one of this example as well. And that's why I want to start with an interview in which yesterday participated Vitalik Buterin. So we know that he's a very important person in the cryptocurrency world. So he's the founder of Ethereum. And I want to say that yesterday in this interview, he talked about NFTs, he talked about Ethereum, he talked about Ethereum 2.0, about the scaling, about this competition, let's say, between the communities of Ethereum and Bitcoin and etc. And of course, about NFTs, one of the coolest topics nowadays. And I want to say that yesterday in this interview, he mentioned Hive. He gave Hive as a nice example of a wonderful community with a good governance that was able to resist the hostile takeover initiated last year by Justin Sun from Tron. And we know that Vitalik Buterin followed closely last year the situation, and it was exactly in March, and he used to tweet a lot in his Twitter account on Twitter and to comment on the ongoing at that time attempt of the hostile takeover of Justin Sun to occupy Hive. However, it was unsuccessful, and that's why Vitalik Buterin, he considers our community as a really very wonderful community with a really perfect governance. And I want to say that this is really very supportive word from the community of Ethereum, and I'm really very happy that they do like us. And once again, that's why I want to say that and even the interviewer, it turned out that he's very familiar with Hive as well. So he also commented on Hive. So definitely we're a great community. It is growing, and this is going to be something massive. Now, let's move on to some other news, because in this interview, Vitalik Buterin talked about NFTs as well. This is one of the big things nowadays, and I want to say that one of the twins, Winklevoss twins, the Bitcoin billionaires, he mentioned on March 10, so a couple of days ago, that Bitcoin brings scarcity to digital money, NFTs bring scarcity to digital art. So I want to say that we see that more and more people nowadays, they talk about NFTs, investors are talking about NFTs, not just digital artists or virtual artists. So it means that money will flow into this industry, and this is something great, to be honest. And I want to say another example is a post that was published yesterday by Blockport on Twitter, for example. I follow them and I check their tweets on a daily basis. So they wrote, breaking, Beeply's 5,000-day collection has sold for $69 million, making it one of the highest ever art auction sales in history. So this is a very nice example of NFT, and I want to say that this is an example that the NFT industry continues to grow. So it's going to be something big. And I want to say, yes, NFTs, they are undergoing some kind of hype nowadays, but definitely with such kind of news and examples, it just means that this hype will continue and a new, let's say, soup industry or soup ecosystem of the cryptocurrency world is going to emerge, to develop and to grow. So I'm really very happy. You can have a look at CoinGecko, and if you check the categories, for example, you can find this category relating to the NFTs, non-fungible tokens. To be honest, today when I checked CoinGecko and when I saw that it has already a market cap of about 10 billions. This is something massive, because just a month ago, it was something close to 1 billion. Later, it grew to 2 billion. I remember last time when I mentioned NFTs, and actually when I talk about the market cap, it was close to 4.5 billion. Now it's 10 billion. So it means that it's growing rapidly. So this is something massive, to be honest. And this is an example that it's going to be a very interesting ecosystem, soup ecosystem of the cryptocurrency world. NFTs are going to be something big. What is this one? Asset-based tokens. Okay. Now let's move on to some other news relating to the cryptocurrency world. Yesterday, I saw an article on CoinDesk that a decentralized exchange for Dogecoin swaps has been launched recently. So it is built on the Komodo blockchain. It's a nice blockchain, to be honest, and I want to say that if I'm not wrong, back in 2019, I had to analyze it for my job. And as I remember, it's a nice blockchain or ecosystem. But the main point here is to talk about DoggyDex. Doggy Decentralized Exchange, it was launched on March 1st. So it's been 12 days since then. And the service is powered by Atomic Dex engine and is available through both desktop and mobile apps. So that's really fun, that's really cool, I like it, because we know that people nowadays talk much more often about Dogecoin if compared to what it used to be a couple of years ago, because now Dogecoin is something really cool when Elon Musk quite often comment on Dogecoin and includes Doggy in his tweets. And I want to say that, of course, yesterday when I saw this article, I decided to check this application, and all links, they sent me to this application on Google Play Market, DoggyDex. I'm not pretty sure that this is the one they are talking about, but it seems like this is the one. So you can have a look at it. From what I see here, it has been downloaded so far just 68 times. So it's not very popular, but we have to keep in mind that this application was launched just 12 days ago on March 1st. So this is something really very still quite new. And I want to say that I will download it. It seems that this is exactly this application, DoggyDex. If I mean the official one, because you know, like in the cryptocurrency world, there are many scams and we have to be really very careful. But I will download it, I will play a little bit with it, and I will see how it works, what it is. It may turn out that it's something cool. So that's it for today, fellas. I hope you like this news, these things that I mentioned today in my video. I wish you a very wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets, and hope to see you in the next one. That was me again at CryptoSpark.